The Waste to Bio project is implemented by the National Technical University of Athens in cooperation with two municipalities in Attica, Papagos Cholergos and Asprópyrgos. It is co-funded by the European Commission in the framework of the Life Plus program, which is the financial instrument of the European Commission for the Environment. Waste to Bio aims to manage the bio-waste produced in our households, which constitutes 40% of the total amount of waste that is sent today to landfills. The target is to produce a second generation of biofuels by making use of our waste, thus recycling valuable materials which are very useful for the production of biofuels for the replacement of fossil fuels. Τα συμβατικά καύσιμα με νέα καύσιμα βιοκαύσιμα. In the framework of the municipality's efforts for improving the residents' quality of life, the Papagos Cholergos municipality decided to participate in the implementation of the Waste to Bio project 4 years ago. The project is a continuation of another successful project, the Dry Waste project, which was also implemented by the NTUA team and us. Our municipality has established an innovative household bio-waste management scheme. The participating households collect and place their bio-waste in a central waste bin with a capacity of 120 liters. It is then transported at the NTUA laboratories as raw material. Another part of the produced bio-waste is dehydrated in households with the use of household waste drying devices, and it is then transported at the NTUA facilities. The municipality's target is to establish waste separation in every corner of the municipality in order to solve the waste handling problem. For this reason, we invest in innovative and reliable waste management and treatment technologies. The Asprópyrgos municipality was a supporter of the project from the very beginning. The necessary actions were quickly implemented in order for the municipality to actively participate in the proposed waste management scheme. It is the first time separate collection bins for household bio-waste have been placed in our municipality. The organic waste is then transported to the NTUA facilities by our waste collection vehicles for further processing. This is an innovation in waste management in a region which has been severely afflicted by the nearby Philly landfill. The municipality is considering further investment in this waste management scheme as well as its expansion in the near future. Our residents have embraced the municipality's call for participation in the project, which proves the success of the proposed waste management scheme. What we have established in the two municipalities is a unique household bio-waste management scheme. More specifically, each resident has received a small kitchen waste bin with a 20-liter capacity where each household places the organic waste produced. When the bag in the bin is full, it is removed and placed in a 120-liter waste bin, which is situated near the household. The bio-waste is then collected by the waste collection services of the municipalities and transported to the NTUA laboratories, where it is dehydrated with the use of a waste drying system. The bio-waste is placed inside the commercial waste dryer, where it is fully dehydrated and turned into dust in just 8 hours.
Λειτουργούν και συστήματα ξύρανσης οικιακού τύπου.
The material is inserted from the upper part of the system. The water contained inside the bio-waste is removed in an economically and environmentally safe way, and it is then collected for further processing. The air passes from a triple active carbon filter in order to remove the unpleasant odors produced during the dehydration process. the final dry product has an 80% reduced mass and volume. It is transported to the bioconversion facility at the NTUA laboratories. The bioconversion facility is comprised of three basic parts. 1. The pre-treatment unit, where the necessary pre-treatment of the dry material takes place with the use of specialized enzymes. 2. The main bioreactor, where the ethanol is produced. 3. The boiler for the production of the necessary amount of steam for the completion of the process. The production process of bioethanol consists of four basic steps. The first step is the heating of the material by adding a small amount of acid. This phase is called pretreatment of the target material. The goal of pretreatment is to make the material more receptive to subsequent processes. The second step is the hydrolysis. During this phase, we use enzymes designed to break down large molecules contained in bio-waste to smaller ones. The choice of the appropriate enzyme depends on the type of macromolecules that we want to bring to a simpler form. Amylases are being used for starch and cellulases for cellulose. By the end of the hydrolysis, the large molecules of the bio-waste have been converted into glucose, ready for assimilation by the microorganisms. In the third step, the fermentation, microorganisms such as yeast, which is known from beer production and bread making, are being used. Yeast metabolizes or consumes glucose, producing ethanol and carbon dioxide. At this stage, bioethanol is dissolved in water. To obtain bioethanol, a further stage called distillation is required. In this stage, ethanol is separated from water, resulting in the pure final product. The bioethanol produced is then ready to be used in fuel blends. This is the first time that a bio-waste management scheme, which includes a dehydration process in order for the final dry product to be used for the production of second generation of ethanol, is implemented. This makes waste-to-bio innovative on an international level. The NTUA project team believes that the use of this technology has great potential. The advantages of the use of this technology are a drastic mass and volume reduction of bio-waste, which is not sent to landfills, and an end product which completes the cycle of the waste management scheme. The value of ethanol is high, since biofuel production from energy crops has eaten into a large portion of the food production. Moreover, the use of the drying method preserves the nutritious characteristics of household bio-waste. The embracing of the waste-to-bio scheme by the residents of the two municipalities of Attica and its simplicity during implementation make it a very reliable waste management scheme.